Today we will look at two examples in the Rhine-Maas river system, Nijmegen and Dordrecht. Nijmegen is a city in the east of the Netherlands, crossed by the river Waal, which is the main distributary branch of river Rhine. Nijmegen is a great example of how large-scale river dynamics can be incorporated into large urban plans. The project that I'm going to show you is part of a national program called Room for the River, which aims to improve the flood resilience of the country by providing space for water in key locations within the river system, including Nijmegen. As you can see in this drawing, from 2005 and 2016, the river Waal crossing Nijmegen received a second branch, a bypass, which released the bottleneck at the sharp turn of the Waal next to Nijmegen. At the same time, this project provided the opportunity for the development of an urban river park on an island between the two branches. So by giving more space for water, but at the same time bringing opportunities for ecology and recreation, this is a good example of multifunctional public infrastructure. Projects like this require a multiscalar understanding of the river system. In the case of Nijmegen, river dynamics, including water discharge and sediments brought from Germany, must be understood at the large scale. Flood risk has to be considered at the scale of the flood protection unit, which is the polder, and at the scale of urban areas, which are in or around flood-prone areas. Finally, riverside urban areas must take into consideration the way people interact with water at the scale of waterside public space. Another example, more downstream on the Oude Maas, is the city of Dordrecht. In this case, we don't have space for water, and the historic center is in danger of being flooded more and more as sea levels from the west and river discharge from the east are rising. Again, the problems of the city of Dordrecht need to be considered on several scales. First of all, the problem of flooding needs to be considered on the scale of the delta. As you can see in these two drawings, several options have been considered by the Dutch Delta program, ranging from a completely closed system, that is total resistance, to an option where water dynamics would be allowed in an open system, that is total resilience. Another way of responding to the resilience strategy is by working on the scale of the whole island and its surroundings. Here we can see the city of Dordrecht. This is the island of Dordrecht, which is much larger than the city. The city can make use of the surrounding natural areas like the Biesbosch here or the outer dike areas on the island of Dordrecht. This way, the absorptive capacity of the area can be improved and solutions can be found together with neighboring municipalities. As part of the Dutch Delta program, the Drecht cities, a group of cities in the area, including the city of Dordrecht, are working towards regional strategies that can have a significant local impact. Having seen these two examples, how can we accommodate water dynamics in urban areas in general? On what scale and what level of governance should the design of public infrastructure be addressed? We will come back to these questions in the assignments.